Hello friends, in this video I am going to show you that how you can create a webhook in SEPA Direct Debit. So in the previous video I discussed about that how you can integrate a payment gateway using SEPA Direct Debit. So in that I told to you that for example in Stripe, might be you have seen that the payment status change after some time. For example, in the beginning, once you have done the payment, at that time the payment status remain pending. But after some time the payment status become changed to the succeeded. So that means if you are updating your database, then at that time once your payment is going to be successful, means at the first time when you are doing payment, then at that time the pending status would be there, so you will update your database with pending status. But if you want that, but the status on that Stripe dashboard, you will find out that there would be succeeded after some time. So how you will be noticed that I should update my status from pending to the succeeded? So that issue has been resolved by using webhook. So webhook is the feature in the Stripe in which once there is any change on the Stripe, then we would be updated by that specific change, and we can able to update our database and anything we can do that we want, right? So here is the description of the webhook, that how you can set the webhook. So here is the code for PHP. You have to add this code. Firstly, you have to add the test key, as well as you have to set the endpoint secret key, and then there would be payload. Payload means whatever would be sent from the Stripe, that would be received in this variable. And then after, you are just putting a Stripe signature, from this you would be validated, and thereafter you will have a try and catch, in which if there would be any exception, then that would be shown to you. And then after that, specific event would be handled using this switch case. For example, the payment intent has been succeeded, then of course you can do something over here. And if the payment method dot attachment and so on, means there are a lot of other events that you can do. So how you can set these events, so I am just showing you that specific part. So I have this database, and you can see over here that SEPA orders table. So I have 10 records, and you can find see that ID, name, email, item name, currency, amount, payment status, and here you can see that pending, and then in some cases there is succeeded. So source status is chargeable, so this is also one of the important status that we needed. So there is payment ID, there is client secret, and here is Stripe source, and here is transaction ID, and then after I have added the response. So in the previous video I already discussed about each and everything. So here is the code. So this is the Stripe library that I have to add into my file. So here is the front end that you have seen on the browser. So name, email, IBN. So that is because of this. And then I have added some JavaScript, actually that is provided by Stripe itself. And then I am just handling the specific input of the user. For example, there is an invalid IBN, then the error would be shown and everything is over here. And then I will create the source, and then that would be sent from here, right? So in this video, the motive is to show you that how you can create a webhook. So here is the webhook code. So firstly, I will run the execute this, and then after you will I will show you that how you can watch that specific thing, right? So here is the payment status. So let's see. So for example, I am Hemant, right? And here is one email, and underneath the hood there are some test keys. So I am putting over here, and then submit. So you will find out here that if I am refreshing this, so you can see the status pending. So right now we have that one create, we have one more record that has been added into the order, but the status is pending up till now, and the source status is chargeable. But after a while, if you will refresh, you can see that here is succeeded. So how does that happen? So let me show you that thing. So actually what I did is, on the Stripe dashboard, you have to click on developers, right? And then after here is webhooks. Actually, I have already created a webhook, sepa_webhook, and here is my domain. So once you will click, then you will find out over here that these are the two events that has been fired from Stripe. So charge.succeeded, that has been handled by my file. So in that, actually there is a JSON that has been sent from here. This is the whole object, and I am just comparing the last part of charge.succeeded. If there would be charge.pending, then that means that we have the pending status. But once that would be succeeded, then of course we can update our database. So we would be noticed once the event would be fired from here, and that would be received, the object would be received on this specific URL. Alright, so let me show you. Actually I have this file, you can see that sepa webhook.php, and here is the database connection file, and here is the Stripe PHP init.php. Actually this is the Stripe library that I have to add here, and then I have to add the secret key, and then I have the endpoint secret. So from where we have to put the endpoint secret, so here is the endpoint secret. Click to reveal. Once you will click over here, then you will find out a specific key. From here you have to copy this and you have to paste over here, right, so that the file would be linked. All right and then after the same code that I have shown already to you here, actually on the documentation you will find out this specific code. Actually you have to copy this same code from here to here, right? And then after I am just handling the event, I am just fetching the source ID from that specific fired event object, right? And then balance transaction as well. So here I have few events: payment intent.succeeded, charge.succeeded, and once charge.succeeded would be fired, then I am going to update sepa_orders table, and payment status converted to the succeeded, and as well as transaction ID I am going to update, and source.chargeable, this is also one of the record that I have to update. For example, in the beginning there is the pending, then after getting the event, then we can update this specific status as well. Alright, so this is the way that how we can actually manipulate this. So I will put this whole code on my Git repository. From there you can get this, and you can only have to change the secret key as well as the endpoint secret, right? And one more thing that I am recommending to you is that require once. So this is actually the library that you have to include into your file particularly. In that we have everything. So because of this we are able to manipulate these things, means we can able to use this Stripe, right? So next thing is, I haven't shown you the transaction ID actually. So here is the transaction ID that we have, right? This is also one of the important that you have to include into your database, right? So all the things has been updated now. And one thing, okay, the transaction successful and order ID is 11, and once you will go back, and then you will find out that you are again on the same page. All right so the succeeded events, the events that you are getting is shown over here. And one thing you can do is update details. For example, you are going to click over here, and there are a lot of other events. You have to put that specific URL over here, right? And you can select the events. For example, I have only two events that I needed, but for example you want to get the charge expired event as well. Once you will click, then that would be shown over here. That means this event also would be fired. But the disadvantage of more events is that there would be a lot of events, then of course the server load would be increased, right? So that means you need not have more events to fire. So you need to be limited, because if you have the particular events that you have needed, then it's okay that you are allowing from here. Otherwise, there would be load on your server, right? So once you will click on edit point, then three events would be over here. So for example, what you want is you want to add a new event, a new endpoint. So here you can click add endpoint. So here you will have to paste the URL. For example, I have this URL, all right, and I'm going to add that to here. And then after I had a new file, sepawebhook.php, so I added, actually I already added that one, just I'm showing you the demo, right? And then you have to select the endpoints, in the sense events, and then after add endpoint, and that would be added to your webhook part, right? So I have only two events up till now, two endpoints only. So wherever these URLs would be, so the event fired from Stripe, the whole object would be received to your specific file. For example, I have this sepawebhook.php, so this file would be called automatically, right? So what you have to keep in mind is that you have to handle those events properly, otherwise you will get a status of failed. For example, you will see that there are a lot of other events that has been failed. So these are failed. So what does that mean? It means that you are not able to handle these in a proper way. All right. So these are the few things that I had to share with you. These are really important, and you have to keep in mind that if you want that your payment status should be updated when the payment has been succeeded on the Stripe, because there are some cases like you have done the payment and on the Stripe you have to wait for 5 days. So at that moment you need not create your own cron file and stuff like that. Why? Because if you are creating the cron, then of course you are responsible for running that. So webhook is providing the facility that once the status would be updated into the Stripe, then you need not bother about that for calling this SEPA webhook, but this file would be called automatically once the webhook would be once the event would be fired from the Stripe itself, right? So in this way we could able to do whatever we want. For example, we are updating our database, so that is happening because of this specific webhook. All right, so if you are not understanding the whole point of view, then of course how I did the integration, I have this charge.php file, so I have all the stuff, I have done all the stuff that I needed. Actually I already discussed in the previous video, in that I showed you that how you can integrate the whole payment gateway, right? This you have seen over here, so I explained in detail. All right, so if you have you are facing any problem, then you have to feel free to ask me any question in the comment section. I will definitely reply you and happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video. All the links of my video courses are below in the description, which are absolutely free. So in the next video we would learn new and wonderful things. Please subscribe this channel firstly to get the information of updated videos. In the comment section you can write your feedback about the video, and also write your queries if you have any. Have a nice day ahead.